You produce. What's in Area 51? Is it aliens or office supplies?
The desperate attempt to somehow link me to aliens, an Elvis comeback album, a two-nosed Osama, and Area 51 is nothing more than another example of how ridicule and condescension are utilized in a last-ditch effort to somehow draw attention away from evidence and information that is damning to the conventional wisdom of the official story.
Shut up. That was University of Wisconsin professor Kevin Barrett, who has recently drawn criticism for plans to teach an Islamic studies course next fall that will incorporate conspiracy theories that the U.S. government was involved in the events of September 11. Professor Barrett joins us now. Professor, can you give us the context within which you teach this?
Well, yeah, sure. I'm teaching an introductory course on Islam, and I think it's really important to cover these contemporary political issues, and one of them is, of course, the so-called war on terror. Now, the fact is that the great majority of the world's Muslims believe that 9/11 was an inside job.
Okay, but that's your opinion, right? That there was an inside job.
Well, after studying the evidence pretty intensively for 2.5 years, I am convinced that 9/11 was, in fact, an inside job.
And are students required to regurgitate that in some way in order to do well in your class?
That's ridiculous. No, I'm not interested in making students regurgitate anything.
All right, Mr. Barrett, Sean Hannity here. Do you really believe that 9/11 was an inside job?
Do you believe personally that
these are inside jobs, yes or no?
It's not quite that simple. I know that 9/11 was an inside job. Professor Stephen Jones has found residue of thermate on the steel samples from the World Trade Center. We now know that it was taken down in a controlled demolition.
All right, so you believe that the buildings came down in a controlled demolition, right?
Well, I don't believe it. I've looked at the evidence, the evidence is overwhelming.
All right, the evidence is overwhelming to you because you're
sure
a conspiracy nut, but
no,
you know,
actually,
putting all that aside...
I ask your viewers to take a look at this evidence for themselves. They can go to st911.org. That's
all right,
Scholars for 9/11 Truth.
Here's,
take a look at the demolition.
I know you think
Morgan Reynolds,
the
former Bush administration official, says that the Bush administration blew the World Trade Center to kingdom come. That's a direct quote from a member of the Bush administration itself. They blew the World Trade Center to kingdom come.
The Jews were told to leave. We've heard a lot of these sick, bizarre theories.
That's
not, I don't believe any of them, but you're allowed to believe what you want, but that's not what's at hand here. The issue is whether or not you, with your bizarre theories, are the best.
I think you have the bizarre theory. You think it was 19 guys with box cutters led by a guy on dialysis in a cave in Afghanistan? That's ridiculous.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the craziest conspiracy theory of all of them.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I wish I had the Twilight Zone music. Now, here's my next question. The issue at hand here, you're entitled to have your opinion. I don't really care what you believe. But if we're talking about a captive group of students in a classroom, the question
I'm not
we've got
hold
to
them captive.
Hang on a second. Well, they're sitting in your classroom, and you have a position of authority. I'm wondering, the question is whether or not you're the most competent to teach them. And most people think you're a nut. Most people think
you're not even worth listening to. We just had a poll here in Madison, and we found that 90% of the respondents at Channel 3000 poll said that I should be allowed to teach. Only 10% said I shouldn't.
That's the question.
And 60%.
I don't think what your views are.
60% agreed with me about the questions I'm raising about 9/11. 60% of the respondents.
I think you're in the minority. I don't think this is the proper forum, though, for people that hold extremist views like yourself. Reasonable
people guys are extremists. Fox News is the biggest bunch of extremists on the planet.
But reasonable people see you as an extremist, and I don't think you're the most appropriate guy to teach that class. My guess is you're the most appropriate guy to be on the airwaves spewing your venom throughout this country.
I think you guys should be taken off the airwaves because you are the guys
silence
who
are, conservative
we don't want to silence anybody.
For,
you teach, we'll do anything
treason,
at home. Thank you, Professor.
Times.
Coming up, we'll have a...
Joining us now from Madison is James Fetzer, a recent retired professor from the University of Minnesota Duluth who supports Barrett. You know, I'm getting a little tired of Barrett and Ward Churchill and other college professors who hate their country and who bring this hatred onto a campus full of impressionable students. Am I wrong to be offended and angry about that, sir?
Well, you are wrong, Bill, because you haven't studied the case. We've created an organization consisting of experts and scholars, pilots, aeronautical engineers, mechanical engineers, structural engineers, civil engineers, physicists. We've been examining what the government's been telling us, and frankly, Bill, it's a fantasy. None of the major claims made by the government can be sustained. We've been looking at this from every point of view. The government has a story it wants to sell us. We're not buying it.
Okay, you don't have to buy anything. You're American. You want to be a nut, you can be a nut. And you are a nut. because in order for any conspiracy of this magnitude to take place, thousands of Americans would have to buy into it, would have to know about it, and would have to keep their mouth shut about it. That's never going to happen. You're like the guys who think that the space aliens kidnapped Elvis or something like that. That's where you are.
We have hundreds of studies. We have documents. We have records.
Well, why can't you get on the front page of the New York Times?
Anyone, Bill, who has even looked at the collapse of Building 7 understands it came down by controlled demolition. It wasn't hit by any
plane. I had guys in here who say you're full of...
Anyone who wants to know the truth should go to st911.org, our website. Scholars for 9/11 Truth, and they'll find it in spades, Bill.
I hope they go to your dopey website, and I hope they read your stuff. So I just want to, this is how crazy you guys are. And you guys are, really. Number one, you hate your country, and number two, you're a loon. Come on. I mean, this, why don't you just say that you have a Martian living in your bedroom, sir? Why don't you just say that and parade a puppet out or something?
We found the government account is provably false on every major respect.
Yeah.
You appear to be among those who can't handle the truth, Bill.
No, I know.
You've
got
to look at our findings. We've conducted objective scientific studies.
We have no funding.
We have no money. We're doing this because we believe in our country. And as a former Marine Corps officer, Bill, I resent your implication. We're interested in the truth and not being deceived.
You hate your country.
The American government.
Look.
Bill, you're obviously not going to give me a chance to talk about any of these things.
No, I'm not, because you're a nut.
Go to our website, st911.org.
All right, we heard your website.
If you want the truth.
Fine. Thanks for being here.
We care enough about our fellow citizens who died, Bill Riley, to find out why they died and how they died, which is more than the government has done.
You have disgraced those people by accusing the president of being a murderer. You can be a nut, and you are a nut, because in order for any conspiracy of this magnitude to take place, thousands of Americans would have to buy into it, would have to know about it, and would have to keep their mouth shut about it.
9/11 was an inside job. 9/11 was an inside job. 9/11 was an inside job. 9/11 was an inside job.
Guys with box cutters led by a guy on dialysis in a cave in Afghanistan? That's ridiculous. Yeah. I mean, that's the craziest conspiracy theory of all of them.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I wish I had the Twilight Zone music. Now,